Hi guys, for today's video, we're going to make a cherry blossom flower. Here are the tools and materials that we're going to use. We have a DIY gum paste, a food color gel, small scissors, ball tools, star tip tool, foam pad, DIY edible glue, brush, small stamens, you can buy that in the stores, baking stores, a white floral tape, and a white floral wires. Not sure about the size, but yeah, and we can start. So first, we prepare the stamen of the cherry blossom. Pick at least 4 pieces of stamen. Fold the stamen in half, then cut the floral wire at least 5 to 6 inches and bend it in half. Insert the stamens in between the wire. So using a floral tape, we secure the stamens by covering the whole wire with tape. So make sure to stretch the floral tape first to activate its stickiness. So gently twist the tape and secure the whole wire. Set aside. Before using your gum paste, you need to knead it properly. Then I'm coloring it with pink because the cake is pink, so you can make any color that you want. Before now, it's pink. So knead and knead to blend the color evenly. Once you're satisfied, now we roll it so we can see the half. So other half should be placed inside the Ziploc. So roll the gum paste between your palm to make a teardrop shape. Using the star tip tool, you press it down. You can see the 5 dents. It signifies the 5 petals. So cut that dents using your small scissors. Alright. Open it carefully. Using your foam pad, we're going to flatten each petals. Brush the petals with some cornstarch. This will prevent the ball tool to stick on it. Use the small ball tool first. Gently rub the ball tool from inside to outside. Repeat that to all petals. You can feel the petals are sticky, so don't hesitate to brush it with cornstarch. Use your bigger ball tool to flatten the petal. Using your bigger ball tool, we push the ball tool inward to curve the petals. Now, once once you're satisfied with the size and the flatness, you can now insert the stamen. Just put enough edible glue. Gently press the gum paste to make sure that the stamen will stick on it. Remove the excess gum paste. Start over again. You must know how to make it because it is too really easy. So I'll make it fast. Just watch and you do the same as I do. Just follow my lead. I'm making smaller size of the flower. You can make it bigger or too small. For this one, just make sure that the bottle will not stick on the gum paste, so brush it with cornstarch. So I'm okay with this one, so I'm pushing it inward. That's good. So put some edible glue on the stem, then carefully insert it. Dry for at least overnight or 24 hours. Here's my tip. I place my flowers under a light bulb. Of course it's lit. Took 1 to 2 hours to completely dry. But the sad part is that the color faded when it is under the light. Maybe it's too hot. So if you're going to do the same, you might want to make your gum paste darker in color. Here I'm preparing the edible dust. I'm using pink and red to make it more realistic. Just put enough dust. Don't make the same mistake that I did. Just mix some red and pink. Depends on your preference. We just start brushing from inside the center of each petal and spread it on side to side. that on all the petals. Center to the sides. Then we do the same at the back of each petals. Other flower. So I'm making it a bit of reddish pink. I prepared to boil the water in here. I'm seeing that our flowers are a bit dry, so let's steam it using the boiling water. Moisture will help our flower to become a more realistic. Yay, we're done! I hope you learned something from my video. Thanks for watching! Up next, Hello Kitty number cake.